Cleaner Media's Mining Weekly is interviewing Jan Nelson, the CEO of Copper 360, the Johannesburg Stock Exchange AltX company, which has revived history by mining the first copper ore in 41 years in South Africa's once copper active Northern Cape. Hi, Jan, it's great to chat to you once again. When last was copper extracted from Rietberg, where Copper 360 is now mining, and what can be expected from this mine going forward?
Hi, Martin. Yes, copper was last mined from this mine in 1983. So, you know, it's almost four decades since copper was brought out of this mine, and we started it up again last week. So we're very happy with that. And I think in terms of what can be expected, we're slowly building up from about 12,000 tons of production this month to about almost 46,000 tons of production over the next 3 to 4 months. And so really, Rietberg is now going to become our cash cow for the company.
And what did it feel like when the first load of ore came out of this reviving Rietberg?
Man, Martin, it was fantastic. You know, actually, Shirley Hayes, which is our chair, you know, and consolidated this whole mining license 16 years ago. She's been working 16 years to get to this point, you know, so she was very proud. We were all proud. It was like watching, you know, your child being born. You know, you've worked on it. You've gone through trials and tribulations. You're worried, is it going to come out right? And then when it's born and it's beautiful and, you know, we're all very proud and very happy. It's a great moment.
And to what extent does this first ore mining activity move the needle forward for Copper 360? You know, you've got a long list of other things. How is this going to move the needle, do you think?
Martin, as we said before, on the mining right that we have, which covers 19,000 hectares, we've got 12 historical mines like Rietberg and 60 prospects. And I think everybody was always worried. You know, we said we had the data sets, the mines had development in, but Rietberg has now shown that the development that has been done for these mines historically can be used. We've obviously done a bit of support work. The grades are there, as we confirmed with drilling. The ore bodies are there. And so it shows that the acceleration of this district can now happen quickly. You know, we've got the template. We've seen what we need to do at Rietberg, and we can roll out the same model at the rest of the complex. You know, we've got a central processing facility, and then we've got this cluster mining model where all these little small mines will start producing together. So I think it will significantly move the needle, and it's going to get us to, in 3 years' time, move to 50 to 80,000 tons of copper production.
And from what Copper 360 has seen so far, where does the copper endowment of the Northern Cape rank when compared with copper endowments of South America, notably Chile, and Central Africa, notably the Democratic Republic of Congo?
I think, Martin, right at the top. And the reason for that is, obviously, if you look at Chile, they produce large volumes of copper, and we're not in that league. But I think what puts us at the top, from my perspective, at the top of that table is the fact that we've got very high-grade ores. You know, we've got 3, 4, 5% sitting on surface. We've got infrastructure. The mines have been pre-developed. And we are low cost. You know, we've got a margin of over 55%. And I think that is what leads me to say that we're in the top. It's all fine and well to say we produce billions of tons of copper, but we don't produce it at a profit, or we produce it at 5% margin. For us, it's all about the margin. And I think that puts us well ahead of any other district in the world. Obviously, we'll have to build this district up now. But in terms of the copper being there, you know, you've got a whole copper district in one area. You've got pre-developed mines. You've got ore bodies on surface with 4 or 5% copper. That's just, you know, that's not heard of anywhere else in the world.
And what is Copper 360's view on the production of clean green copper? You know, copper has for long been fittingly referred to as the green metal, but there's different meanings for green these days. What is your attitude to green metal?
I think it's important, Martin. It's important that you produce your metal at a profit, because, you know, you are excavating and taking out ore. So you must do it at a profit, not at a loss, because that's detrimental to the environment. But I think in terms of the green revolution, you know, copper, again, cannot be replaced. And if you want to conduct electricity, you need copper. And for developing a better and greener world, electric vehicles, infrastructure, you need copper. And it is just that metal that is going to transform the world as well, in terms of it being a better place. So we've got a very positive view on copper being the green metal.
And Is it economically feasible for Copper 360 to add more value to copper itself prior to on-selling the metal? And what forms could be, greater beneficiation take?
Yes, Martin, our Chief Operating Officer, Gordon Thompson, with some of our technical people like Jacqueline Wyeth, our Chief Technical Officer, is already working on what we call the 5-9s plan. And that is a plan where in the next 3 years, we intend to build a small smelter and where we ultimately want to make copper wire and pipe. And therefore produce the product, not just ship out the plates. And then later we buy copper wire and pipe back, but that we can actually do that ourselves. And it's quite feasible to do that. And then we add a lot of value. And it's also good for the South African economy in terms of, the government and the DMR wants us to move to beneficiation, which I think is the right step. So it's quite feasible. And we're already busy with our planning for that.
That's great news. And how are skills developing at the Copper 360 School of Mining?
That's going very well, Martin. Our programs keep on rolling out. It's become our super training center in the Northern Cape for developing skills. And all is going very, very well there with the programs that we're rolling out.
And what else should the market be alerted to when it comes to Copper 360 and its vision, the medium-term vision, long-term vision?
Martin, yes, I think we've had very supportive and patient shareholders. Building mines is a very capital-intensive process. So, we've spent a lot of capital to get where we are with some very patient family and friends and shareholders and institutions. And I think what they can now look forward to is that we're transitioning from spending capital to now generating cash, becoming extremely cash positive, able to pay a dividend, and then fund our growth from internal cash flow and becoming a significant copper producer in Southern Africa.
And when it comes to Rietberg, have you already got offtake for that ore that's coming out?
Yes, Martin, we have. We've got offtake agreements in place. The ore currently will be processed through the Namakopa plant that we bought recently. And then we're 2 months away from commissioning our second plant that we've built. And that will treat all the Rietberg ore. And we've got the offtake agreements in place for all the ore that will come from Rietberg.
That was Creamer Media's Mining Weekly, speaking to Jan Nelson, the CEO of Copper 360, the Johannesburg Stock Exchange AltX company that is progressing fast as a surface and underground copper mining company.